What's going on, New Orleans? How y'all feeling? Oh, y'all could do better than that. What's happening, New Orleans? How y'all feeling? There we go. I'm back home, and I'm even if it's for a short time, I'm so happy to be back. I just came back from Paris, and I led my first band in Paris at Duc de Lombard. Thank you. But there is nothing like being home and playing for my family and playing for my friends. Thank y'all so much for being out here. Please give a round of applause to Gladney on tenor saxophone. Mr. Steve Lanz on the trumpet. Mr. Shea Pierre on the piano. And my brother, Mr. Max Moran on the bass. That first tune that you heard is a composition off of my debut release, Look Within. And it's a composition written by my mother's favorite composer, which happens to be me. I gotta thank Donald Harrison for that one. I stole that one. that was the original composition entitled Fleeing Fate. It actually has duality to it. Me and Gladney was talking about it. He was like, what is the title actually? Because on the record, it's something different from what's written on the chart. Fleeing Fate, and it's the other title, it's Fleeting Faith. This was actually done by, the concept of the song was actually from a dream that I had. It's like this big blob that I was just encompassing. It was always coming to me, and I was trying to figure out how to get around it. And I couldn't go around it, and I couldn't go above it, I couldn't go below it. I had to go through it, and then once I went through it, it was like this burst of energy that I had. So it's like this duality of fleeting faith and also fleeing fate. So this next tune that we're gonna do is entitled Mystics, and this composition is by a great trumpeter, Steve Lanz. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Mr. Steve Lanz, Mystic. This next one that we're gonna do is by this great, brilliant mind who I've had the pleasure of knowing for quite some time. I first met him, we were both teenagers, but I was a little older than him and had the title of student teacher, and he was in my class, but I was learning from him because he had a sense of harmony, a sense of melody, a sense of rhythm. I mean, he had a full grasp, all on his own, and super humble. Please give y'all a round one of applause for Mr. Shea Pierre on the piano. This tune that we're gonna do is entitled Ground Level. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
this man is going straight to the universe, throughout the universe, I'm telling you. Shape the air. This next tune that we will play for you all is a composition by a person that is very dear to my heart. I've been knowing this man since we were kids. I mean, really, I've been knowing the majority of these guys on stage since we were kids. But with this gentleman, we've met when we was like, what, 14? And I met him actually without words. I met him on stage, hurrying up to plug into the amp, and he immediately played the melody to So What. We were on stage. I like to brag about this. We wasn't playing for Omarion, but we was playing for Omarion's brother. We were opening up for Omarion's brother. Orion was his name, if y'all like the 2000s. But anyway, we was playing with Chris Royal. It was Chris Royal, Josh Connolly on guitar, Conan Pappas on piano, and this gentleman, Mr. Max Moran, on the bass. Max, we were missing the bass player, and they were rushing us on stage, and Max walked on stage, cool as ever, and just plugged in and played this bass line, and I was like, who is this funky you-know-what? And after we performed, I was just like, man, I knew Conan, and I just met Max. We said hi for the first time, and it was love at first sight. And I said, hey, I'm going to Anoka this year. I know you guys are going to Anoka. I feel like we should do something. We should start a band or play together or something. And we did. We played together for the next, 2.5, 3 years. And then our senior recital, we formed a band called The Bridge Trio. And we all collectively write for this band, and they are more prolific than I am, I should say. I love all of their compositions. And one of the compositions we're going to play for you tonight is an original composition by Max. It's also featured on the Bridge Trios project. This one is entitled Undying Love. One more time for Mr. Max Moran on the bass. Now, before we do this next tune, I have to check one thing. Ellie Mae, are you here? Okay. The person that I just called literally knows where the bodies are. This is my sister, Joelle Dyson. You cleaned up nicely. I don't want to go on and on because I could tell stories all night. But it's amazing to see this beautiful queen emerge into the presence of everything that she embodies. Right now, she not only is a great vocalist and a great artist and a great singer-songwriter, but she has created an organization, a company that gives back to the community. She has a program called Beyond the Stage. And I'm not sure if you've seen it, but she's literally been on billboards. She has advertisements on buses going by and all type of stuff. This is her company. She's put all that together. And she helps so many students within this city. And these students have matriculated from knowing no music, knowing the basic fundamentals. She puts them through the rings, and they have learned so much where they're now going to NOCA. She's gotten them into auditioning past the audition stage to get into these programs, and now she has students that have actually graduated high school and now have gone to college, still studying under tutelage of music. And the reason why I'm taking this time to talk about this is because in the city that we all live in and that we know and we love, there's a lot of things that have been portrayed about our youth, and we're always saying we need to do something about it. And she has put on the bootstraps and she's doing something about it. So I want you guys to support that program.
Gonna make you cry.
Now that's just that one thing. She's also writing, she has her own projects out. He Loves Me, He Loves Me Not. I'm a fan of hers. I try to listen to everything. Without asking her. Anyway, I had the opportunity to put this song together for my record. It's actually the self-titled track to my debut release, Liquid Thin. And we recorded it with this great band, with Gladney and Steve, a few other guys. And went in the studio, put it all together, and I was just like, something is missing. So I cut it down, and I was just like, I know what to do. I finally wrote some lyrics. I piecemealing lyrics all over the place. I was touring at the time between everybody, Pat Metheny, Nicholas Payton, all type of people. And finally got some lyrics together and had a studio date. Donald Harrison put a studio date together. He knew that I needed studio time to engineer, and he said, you can have some of my studio time and do whatever you need, because I'm just doing one song. He booked the whole day, and I basically was able to go in and finish what I needed because of him. And I told Joelle the night before, I was just like, Joelle, I'm coming over to your house because I have lyrics. You got to hurry up and learn these lyrics, and you got to sing this tomorrow because we're recording.
No lie.
And she did exactly that.
He did it last night, too.
She did exactly that. And obviously, you could tell our relationship. I'm always putting her under the fire, and she always arises to the occasion. One more time for Joelle Ellie Dyson.
Thank you.
This next tune that we're going to do again is entitled Look Within. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
place where you'll find a hope and joy and peace within. Look within. Even when life looks like a dark and full of grin, in you find peace within. Take a breath of life and look within. In you find peace within. Spread your love from me, and there you will see. The source to love divine, you'll find a path that is within. You'll find love, peace that gives a sense, a heart of joy that could spark the light within. Peace that gives, da da da, da da da.
Joe Dyson.
You guys got a real special treat because that's actually the first time we've actually played that live with her singing. Okay, here comes the fun part. We are going to tell you what we'll play after we play it. Drum solo. Thank you. That last tune that you heard was entitled Red, and that is penned none other than the illustrious Max Moran. I want you guys to know that all of these guys are band leaders in their own right. They all have their own projects out. So I think now is the time to write their names down if you do not know who they are, because you will never pay $10 again to see them. starting with our tenor saxophonist, Mr. Gladney. And on the trumpet, my brother, I haven't been able to tell a story about him yet, but I have to in this moment. Steve Lanz is an incredible artist. I can't just say trumpeter because he has a brilliant mind. He's been doing a lot of great things. I think the latest that you may have known him to do in the city right now is his project Planets. Yeah. I would definitely try to check that out anytime he's promoting it, because that's another one that's going to skyrocket for sure. But I first met Steve. We played a gig. I might have either still been in high school or just finished. I was in my freshman year, I believe. We were playing a performance with our friend, a tenor player. What's my man's name? I'm getting to that age now. Like, oh, what's his name? Again? He was Quamon Fowler. We were playing with Quamon Fowler, who's a great, who's another brilliant mind. All of us have a connection to Elvin Batiste on the stage, and that's where I first met Quamon Fowler, and through Quamon, I met Steve Lanz. They came down from Baton Rouge to perform at Snug Harbor, and Quamon had some hard music. And we came to sound check. We got there early, and it took literally minutes before the stage for us to get through that sound check. But it was incredible, because that was the first time I got to play with them, and then afterwards, we got to play again with another good friend of ours, Jesse McBride. He put a big band together. Yes, please put a round of applause. He put a big band together entitled the Next Generation, Next Gen Big Band. And we would steal moments together. Like every take that would finish, everybody would congregate or go, you know, grab some food. And Steve would run to the drum room. And I would always stay in the drum room, and we'd steal a few moments away and play together, whatever it may be. And you can just tell that there was some type of synergy there. And I always said, I'm going to have him at some point in my band. And I was able to have him read through some of my earliest charts and help me make revisions when needed. And he also is his sound that's on a record that helped bring the music to life, and I really appreciate him for it. So Mr. Steve Lanz on the trumpet. Mr. Shea Pierre over there on the piano. I told y'all the early story, but I didn't tell you that he also played at my church for many years. He was the organist. And just truly incredible. He has his own projects out right now. I purchased the first one. It was the first ever that I've seen anything like it. It was a cookbook that had music attached to the cookbook. So it's a vegan cookbook at that, right? So you guys, if y'all want, you know, to make sure you have a healthy lifestyle and also be blessed with some beautiful sounds, go look up Shea Pierre. And here's my brother again, Mr. Max Moran on the bass. I can still tell more stories about Max. But he has his own project out called Neospectric. And it's literally a new word that he's created. And we all have been a part of that project. And he's not, he has that project out, the album out, but he's also been doing film scoring. So that's probably why you haven't seen him as much. He's been behind the scenes. So please look out for everything that he's doing. This next tune that we're going to do, and this is actually, I believe it's going to be our last number. This is a song by a great tenor saxophonist, Gladney, and this one is called Selenite.
Yes, indeed. All right, now that y'all got your hands all warmed up, I'm gonna need y'all to give us some claps in this song. Is that all right? And later on, I'm gonna need y'all to pay attention because there's gonna be some singing too. Is that all right? All right. Share a truth with you. There resides a light inside of you. I see that eye between your brows. Don't deny the light inside of you. Share a truth with you. There resides a light inside of you. I see that eye between your brows. Mm-hmm. Don't deny the light inside of you. Share a truth with you. There resides a light inside of you. It's true. I see that eye between your brows. Mm-hmm. You don't deny the light inside of you. Selenite will get you right. Mm-hmm. I share with you what the ancients knew. Mm-hmm. This stone can clear pain, tension, and fear from you. We'll be right back. Nadia. Ha, do he do lead Dio. Dio, Nadia, Nadia. Ha, do he do lead Dio. Now, if these words resonate with you, respond in kind and give a big heed. And if these words resonate with you, respond in kind and give a big heed. Hold up. Thank you, thank you. I ain't hearing no mm-hmms though. It's simple, it's one word. Now if these words resonate with you, respond in kind and give a big And if these words resonate with you, respond in kind and give a big resonate with you, respond in kind and give a big If these words resonate with you, respond in kind and give a big And if these words resonate with you, respond in kind and give a big
One more time for Gladney on the tenor saxophone and the vocals. Mr. Steve Lands on the trumpet. Mr. Shea Pierre on the piano. Mr. Max Moran on the bass. Sitting in with us earlier, my beautiful sister, Joelle Ellie Dyson. My name is Joe Dyson. Thank y'all so much for coming out. So great to be home, and it's so great to see all y'all beautiful faces. Please continue to support this organization and continue to support live music. Continue to support live music, continue to support live music, and continue to support all of the composers who are continuing to write music for today. Y'all have a blessed one. Thank you.